In this video, we define series and parallel combinations of capacitors, and we quickly derive formulas for the equivalent capacitance given by a combination of capacitors. We wrap things up by giving simple examples of series and parallel combinations of capacitors. So on the left, we have a picture of two capacitors in series. And what I'm going to do for clarity is label a couple nodes in the circuit. I'm going to call these A and B. And we know that C1 and C2 are in series because there is no other branch connecting A and B except to go through both of those capacitors. So that's what defines a series combination. Our goal here is to snip those out of the circuit and replace them with a single equivalent capacitance between the points A and B. So we're trying to find the number on Ceq so we could take these two capacitors and replace them with one, and the behavior of the circuit would be identical. So when I hook this capacitor combination up to the battery, I'm going to have some movement of charge. I'm going to have a charge of plus Q leaving the bottom plate of C2 and arriving at the top plate of C1. Removing the plus Q from that bottom plate leaves a deficit of charge and negative charge of negative Q. All right, what happens next is that I'm going to end up with a negative Q migrating from the top plate of C2 to the bottom plate of C1. And that leaves behind a positive charge on the top plate of C2. So each of these capacitors ends up with the same charge magnitude. Well, these capacitors are charged now, and so they have a potential difference across them that will depend on their individual capacitances. And so I can say I found one way of measuring the voltage from point A to point B, V1 plus V2. Now, if I snip these out of the circuit and replace them with an equivalent capacitor, I can look at the charge on that capacitor, and it's going to be a plus Q for the top plate. That's the charge on the high side of C1, and a minus Q on the bottom plate. That's the charge on the low side of C2. And I have a potential difference across this that I might call VEQ. And that potential difference across the equivalent capacitor, well, that's equal to the potential difference from A to B, because A is directly connected to the high side of the capacitor and B to the low side of the capacitor. So setting these two expressions for VAB equal to each other, I find that V equivalent is equal to V1 plus V2. Now, just as a little side note, I can remind you of the definition of capacitance as charge per volt, and that means the potential difference across the capacitor is given by the charge on it divided by the capacitance. This allows us to take our voltage equation and express it in terms of the individual capacitances. So VEQ, that's given by Q over CEQ. V1, that's given by Q over C1, and V2 is given by Q over C2, and I arrive at my standard formula for computing the equivalent capacitance of a series combination of capacitors. Note that by leaving it in this form, it's easily extendable to three series capacitors. You would just add on a plus 1 over C3 to this. So I prefer to keep it in this form rather than solving for CEQ. Let's look at a quick example. I'm given a 100 picofarad capacitor, that's 10 to the negative 12th, and it's wired in series with a 200 picofarad capacitor. Let's get the total capacitance. We should be able to just work in units of picofarads. So I have 1 over CEQ equals 1 over C1, that's 150 picofarads, plus 1 over 200 picofarads. And the way I normally handle this in a calculator, I'll just take 1 over 150 plus 1 over 200, press enter, and then do 1 over that answer, and I get the reciprocal of the left-hand side, in other words, CEQ. If I follow the units in that calculation, I've done 1 over 1 over picofarads, and so the units will come out in picofarads, and I get a total of 85.7 picofarads. All right, let's take a look at a parallel combination of capacitors. And so this time, I'm going to label my nodes A and B right here and here. And our mission here is to snip that parallel combination out of the circuit and replace it with a single equivalent capacitance. Now, I can tell this is a parallel combination because there's two branches. There's a choice here for which way current goes. One branch goes through C1 all the way from the high side of the battery to the low side. The other one goes through C2 from the high side of the battery to the low side. Now, the thing that stays the same for each capacitor this time is not the charge, but the potential difference. Each of those capacitors is directly connected to the high and low side of the battery, So each one's going to have that same potential difference of V. C1 is going to end up with a charge of Q1 on it. C2 is going to end up with some other charge, Q2, on it. And my equivalent capacitor, well, the total charge on that will be the sum of these two charges on the high side of each of those capacitors. I'll just call that QEQ for now. And again, the potential difference across CEQ is exactly the same as for C1 and C2 because it directly sees the high and low sides of the battery. So this time I get a handle on the relationship between C1, C2, and C equivalent by saying that the total charge on the equivalent capacitor better be equal to the charge on the two individuals put together. Then I get a little reminder from the definition of capacitance, how I could relate these charges to voltage and capacitance. I solve for Q and I get CV, so Q equals CV. And that means for my equivalent capacitor, I have the equivalent capacitance times V. And V, again, is the thing that's the same for every one of these. For Q1, I could write that as C1V, and for Q2, I could write that as C2V. And this time, the Vs cancel out, and I arrive at my formula for the equivalent capacitance when capacitors are wired in parallel. We'll finish with a quick example. I have a 200 microfarad capacitor wired in parallel with a 400 microfarad capacitor. Give me the total capacitance. And all I do is add these things. 200 microfarads and 400 microfarads. And I've got an equivalent capacitance of 600 microfarads. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.